Good morning and welcome Saab team here in Finland, and it's a pleasure for us also. It's this first time Gripen E is flying abroad and especially in Finland. So I have the same presentation now in third time, so I briefly describe in what stage we are in the HX program. So I've been many times asked what is the weather look like, what is the best weather for the testing. So I would say this morning was really good example about good bad weather. So we had a snow grain, meaning that it's icy condition both in the airframe itself and also causing some bad friction for the runways. So that's the kind of test weather we'd also have, like to have also. But of course would like to have also minus 20 degrees and a sky also to be tested also electrical systems and electro-optic system also. So next please. Yeah. Okay, I would like to highlight about the schedule itself. So we have to have fully operational capability by 2030 with all tenders. And that's how the HX schedule has been built up. And to be in reach that, so meaning we have to have IOC by late 2027, meaning that in the beginning of 28 we could have a one squadron operational with the new HX fighter. And how we can achieve that schedule is meaning that we have to have first aircraft arriving either in Finland or in Sweden or other nation by 2025 to start our own training. And it's huge event in our Air Force also to skill up all the capabilities to put up a training syllabi and get the operational pilots enough to be capable to operate full fleet of HX. And what comes to the HX program this spring itself is also quite busy for the other team than eval team also. So we are expecting to have tomorrow responses about each tender and our RFQ, revised RFQ response. And in springtime we have negotiations round four with each tender, and we try to together build up best capabilities out from each tender. And our best and final offer will be sent by summer or by autumn. Next, please. Even though military capability is only one which will be ranked, all the other decision-making areas are also really important. I would like to highlight that we have a combined planning exercise together with each tender to form up best solution which could actually pass all the steps in our decision-making model. And to get security supply passed, it means that we have to be capable to independence operations stated in our RFQ as a time frame, meaning that logistical lines are cut or in communication lines are cut. And affordability, our government has given us as 10 billion maximum budget. We have to put everything on that. So meaning if you have to build up any infrastructures or whatever needed here inside of Finland, that must be also covered in that same budget. Another tough issue is that operational costs must be at the level of current F-18. So if any tender have problems to solve out those items, so we have to come back in the lowest level and define better solution which can actually pass that step. But if you can easily pass that step, you can also don't put extra money on that. You can go directly to the military capability area and put some extra capabilities over there. So that's how we are planning those capabilities. And same for the industrial participation. So our Minister of Defense, Jussi Niinistö, put us as 30% of total value of budget must be covered by industrial participation. So we are aiming at either direct participation, meaning that that could help us to build up our sustainment solution inside here in Finland. We can also have some indirect industrial participation also, but those must be included direct to our defense force capabilities. It could be like test and modeling whatever capabilities build up in holding the defense forces side. And also same issue. Don't put extra money on that items to get everything out from the military capability side. And if you can read about those industrial participation requirements, we are once again we come at a lower level and design our model and get to build up the better package for the each tender. Next please. So we have a capability-based approach, and here in HX Challenge we are testing aircraft itself and its connectivity to other aircraft and our C2 systems or command and control systems also, how it been networked. But of course that's not only way what will be tested. So we test also how the missions are planned, so how the mission planning systems are working, how the mission debriefing systems are working, how can we get everything out from the test flight and debrief afterwards, and we discuss also what kind of sensor suites and other systems should be required to pass those scenarios that we have put in our RFQs. And for being capable to operate as in our Air Force doctrine, by the Air Force doctrine, we have to have also some kind of logistical system which give us capability to disperse our aircraft, meaning that we have to build up our agile combat support system here inside the Finnish Air Forces. So being capable to use civilian airfields and maybe in highway strips also. And in the bottom side of this picture is that we have to have also some training and testing capabilities inside of Finland to be capable to build up own training syllabi and also being capable to do some research and development inside the Finnish Air Force. And my side is that we are capable to put some good tactics, techniques and procedures on board when we are operating, and we are fully capable to operate with the Gripen E solution in this there. Next please. So we have five mission areas what will be tested also in here, but those are our operational requirements stated by our defense forces. So counter air is the most critical one, because whatever missions you are conducting in airborne, you always may are facing that against the fighters or against the ground-based air defense. So you have to have capability to survive and also defeat your enemy aircrafts. And we also have to have capability to support our army, and that's been done by counter land operations, just different mission sets inside that areas. We have to have capability also to operate and support our Navy, that's in counter sea operations. And like today, we all already had long range strike capability, that's also one requirement put it in our Defense Force headquarters. And new area is intelligence surveillance and target acquisition to build up, how to actually build up the situational awareness inside the Defense Forces. How well we can support our Army, Navy and Defense Force Command to build up the enemy order of battle and that kind of items in operational environment. And because environment here in Finland is challenging, it's both in weather side and also in some operational aspects, you have to have capability to operate on all in these conditions, and those will be tested in our evaluations. Next please. And this HX Challenge, we are now in bottom of this evaluation matrix. So we are testing here mainly about how the system requirements are behaved here in other than our circumstances stated in our scenarios. So we have those five mission sets. We have put those requirements as a scenarios in our RFQ. Those are same in revised RFQ. And it's 10 days options how they will put the concept of operations and solve the problem what we had put on those scenarios. And we test now in here not the capabilities about the system itself. We test what, in this case, what Saab has put in the response, and if needed, that the radar must detect targets in 100 kilometers. So is that valid, that the numbers what they have put in the responses? And this is not the stage that we are putting each tender and ranking those tenders. We are just optimizing, it would say like it's like a risk mitigation system. So is it true what they have been answers given to us? And also this put some challenges to each tender, so when they are giving some responses for us, so don't put some extra numbers and just put some truth numbers, because those will be tested. And those tests will be used in next level when we go to capability requirements, so how well we can conduct in simulations and with the virtual simulations also those scenarios. We fly those scenarios with the simulators and we use these numbers being tested here in this first stage of evaluations. And finally, when we go to the operational level, we have a operational war game in here in Finnish Defense Forces, and we test in like 2 weeks war gaming how well each tender can conduct and operate it in each package what they are building up. So the package must include also enough numbers of weapons and all the sensors and all the logistical support equipment needed to disperse and use operations. Next, please. So each tender has 3 weeks to substantiate data. This is second week what we are doing here in HX Challenge. Every tender has 7 days. To show about the capabilities, and together with the Gripen team we have built up and pick up test events here in this week what will be tested during the whole week, and that's how it's done. So unfortunately we can't go details about testing events itself, but it's, I would say, like Komaro here and Aki Heikkinen already told, that events are well picked up and we are pretty sure that all the major events will be tested. Any questions for me? So
thank you, gents. Please introduce yourself and the media you are representing. We will have time for a couple of questions here before.
Kettunen from Suomen sotilas magazine. Beside the planes themselves, will you also be testing support equipment?
Yeah, those will be tested in the later on. So of course here we see here how is turnarounds done here with the equipment, and of course we test also what is the turnaround times, to that those timing will be used in war gaming also. So it's really important to know everything what will be needed to operate the aircraft itself.
Globalize part of Saab's bid, but I didn't see it on the schedule. How and when will you be testing that platform?
It will be tested so that our team is in Linköping now, currently. And if weather permits, it will also land here in the Pirkkala airbase. But they come from the Sweden flight and test it in our test range here in our own airspaces. So, and our test team is in the Sweden currently, so going inside of the Globalize. But I guess Saab is coming more to roll about how it's been done here during this week. So.
Alan Warnes, a freelancer. Can you tell us how important is the road-based concept as part of the HS acquisition?
It is in Finland, because we are lacking some air bases, so meaning that we have to disperse and to be capable to disperse enough well, so meaning that we have to use also road bases, and those will be tested when we are doing some landings either in here in Pirkkala and doing also some taxiing tests here in Pirkkala, and we are using other air bases also, so which are putting some challenges over there.
And are you happy with the security that would be at the road bases for the future acquisition?
Yes. So we use as also reservists in our Finnish Defence Forces. So our wartime, as a peacetime, we have roughly 2,000 people working in our air forces. So we have 1,500 conscripts, but in as a wartime scenarios, we have 25,000 people working in our air forces. And mainly of those are who are protecting our air bases.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
John Lake, freelance. With security of supply, can you clarify what your aspirations are in terms of being able to have sovereign national mission data, and what are you looking for from the HX contenders in terms of what they can provide?
I'm sorry, I can't go to details, but So we have put some 7 critical requirements in our RFQ, but those are classified, those numbers, and what we are evaluating and testing and assessing is how well we can modify our mission data files if needed, if some changes happens here in our operational environment. So how it's done, it's depending on each nations. There's lots of variations. And it's not full requirement. Everything must be done here in Finland or tested in Finland. But of course, most of those must be tested also in Finland side. So if you have like some kind of hardware in the loop, test bench in the UK side or in Sweden, we can use also those benches if needed. But for being capable to operate and change your mission data files, that's the requirement. And then also there's a, I would say, really tough requirements in our RFQs.
So you feel you need to have the ability to update mission data in country?
Update and modify, yeah. What is needed to update and how to modify, of course, it's aircraft dependent.
So if a contender can't allow you to modify your own mission data in country, that would be a fail?
Not so strictly. You have to have capability to modify your mission data files. If it's some restrictions which are done outside of Finland, so, but in certain period of time you can do it, so it's then it's passed. So more, how to say, I can't go to the details. That's to put certain time in our requirement, what must be done here in Finland, and of course you know that you have your own data, you have different data, and you put those data together, and that's always dependent how countries are cooperating. So,
okay.
So mainly you have to have capability to modify it.
Right.
Yeah. So,
and
so
that
for
doesn't need to be done in Finland necessarily.
Mainly.
Okay.